Welcome dear students. Now in today's video lecture we will study module number 3, that is transformer. Now in this particular module number 3 transformer, the following are the contents which we are going to study. The first one is definition of transformer. Second one is construction of transformer. And third one is the working principle. Fourth one is the EMF equation of transformer. Fifth one is losses in a transformer. And next one is efficiency of a transformer. And followed by condition for maximum efficiency. And lastly, we will study about the voltage regulation of a transformer. A transformer is a static electrical machine or a static electrical device which transfers electrical power from one circuit to the another circuit. Okay, in a transformer basically there are two circuits which are called as primary circuit and secondary circuit. So a transformer, what it does is it basically transfers the electrical power from the primary circuit to the secondary circuit. Now important thing here is that in this transfer of power, in the sense particularly the voltage level, the frequency remains constant. The important thing here is that the frequency remains constant. Now, necessity of transformer. Why we are using transformer? The basic use of a transformer is to increase the voltage level and to decrease the voltage level. If a transformer is used to increase the voltage level, then this transformer is referred to as a step-up transformer. On the other hand side, if a transformer is used to decrease the voltage level, then it is referred to as a step-down transformer. On the other hand, if voltage remains same, then that transformer is called as one-to-one transformer. So I hope it is clear. I will define it once again, the definition of transformer. A transformer is a static electrical device which is used to transfer the electrical power from one circuit to the another circuit. Here important thing is that the frequency remains constant. Only the voltage varies from one AC voltage level to the another AC voltage level. A key application of transformers is in economically transmitting and distributing electrical power over long distances. The general practice is to generate AC voltage at about 11 kV and then step up into higher voltages up to 132 kV to 400 kV by using a step up transformer. You can see here from 11 kV range the voltage is increased to 132 kV and up to 400 kV. Here from 11 kV the voltage is raised, the voltage is increased. So the purpose of transformer to use it is used to increase the voltage level, then it is step up transformer and then fed it to the transmitting lines. At the distribution point, the transformer is used to reduce the voltage or to decrease the voltage from 400 volt to 220 volt to be used in industries offices homes small size transformers are used in communication circuits in radio and TV circuits as well as in control systems. Now we'll study the construction of a transformer. A transformer basically consists of two parts. First one is the core and second one is windings. As you can see, the core of the transformer is either square in shape or it can be a rectangular in shape. The vertical portions, there are two vertical portions. As you can see, here is one vertical portion, here is another vertical portion. These two vertical portions, they are called as, or they are referred as limbs of a transformer. The horizontal position, the top horizontal position as well as the bottom horizontal portion, they are called as yoke of the transformer. The purpose of the core is that it provides magnetic circuit. And this core is made up of iron. The material which is used for making the core of a transformer is iron. Okay, one more important thing regarding the core is that the core is laminated using silicone steel. And that too, this silicone steel should have high permeability and low hysteresis coefficient. I'll write it here. It's low hysteresis coefficient. Generally, why we will go for lamination? Lamination is done in order to protect. Likewise, we can see that we are laminating our documents. The purpose of the lamination is to provide safety. Why? Because in a transformer, eddy currents are there which will flow or which will circulate in the core of the transformer, and chances are that the transformer's core might get damaged. In order to protect our transformer's core, what we are doing is we are laminating the core of a transformer using silicone steel. And the characteristics of this silicone steel is that it should have high permeability as well as low hysteresis coefficient. Second basic part of a transformer is windings. As we can see that there are two windings which are wound on two limbs of the core. As in a human being we are having legs, likewise in a transformer we are having limbs. The primary winding, there are two windings. As you can see in the figure, this side of the figure where voltage V1 is used is the winding which is connected to the supply side is referred to as primary windings, and it is denoted by P. This primary winding is having N1 number of turns in it, and the winding which is connected to the load is referred to as secondary winding. This secondary winding is designated by S, and this particular secondary winding is having N2 number of turns in it. The material which is used for making the windings of a transformer is copper. Now lastly, in the construction we will see the circuit symbol of a transformer. This particular figure depicts the circuit symbol of a transformer. Here we can see that there are two circuits. This circuit is the primary circuit and this circuit is the secondary circuit, and this is the supply voltage which is designated by V1. This is the primary winding which is having N1 number of turns. The primary current I1 is flowing through the primary winding. This is the secondary circuit. In a secondary circuit, we are having N2 number of turns. This, of course, is the load, and the voltage across the load is nothing but V2, which is called as terminal voltage or the secondary terminal voltage. I2 is the current which is flowing through the load. Now, many of the students, they are having a confusion. How to identify whether a given transformer is a step-up transformer or a step-down transformer? One important thing to identify or to distinguish between the two type of transformers is through the circuit symbol. Now, you can see that here N1 number of turns are there, here N2 number of turns are there. Now, from the figure, it is clear that N2 is greater than N1. We can see more number of turns in N2. N1 is having less number of turns. When N2 is greater than N1, this type of transformer, it is referred to as step-up transformer. On the other hand side, if the number of turns in the primary winding are more and the number of turns in the secondary winding are less, I can write N2 less than N1, then we will classify the transformer as step down transformer. Lastly, I will show you when both the number of turns N1 and N2 are same, what might be the transformer referred to as? This type of transformer, when N1 is equal to N2, the number of turns in the primary is equal to the number of turns in the secondary, this transformer is referred to as a one-to-one transformer. So this concludes the construction of a transformer.